Both the Saab 97X 4.2i and Volvo XC90 3.2 offer the luxury, versatility, and sporty performance expected of vehicles in their segment. The 2009 Saab 97X continues to be the exclusive choice for buyers who desire Scandinavian design, powerful engines, responsive handling, and luxurious amenities, along with all of the versatility and utility of an SUV. In this video, we'll compare the Saab 97X 4.2i against one of its primary competitors, the Volvo XC90 3.2. The Volvo XC90 3.2 is carried over for 2009 with only minor cosmetic enhancements to its exterior and additions to its list of standard and available features, including a new standard 36-month or 36,000-mile no-charge maintenance plan. In addition to providing key product comparisons, we'll also use this icon throughout the video to highlight 97X advantages over the XC90. The Saab 97X 4.2i's inline six-cylinder engine is both powerful and remarkably quiet. Mated to a four-speed automatic transmission with adaptive shift control, the i6 delivers a robust 285 horsepower and an equally impressive 276 pound-feet of torque. The Volvo XC90 with 235 horsepower and 236 pound-feet of torque falls far short of the 4.2i's performance, providing the 97X 4.2i with advantages of 50 horsepower and 40 pound-feet of torque. And the 4.2i's power advantage also provides Saab customers with more than a 1,600-pound advantage in maximum towing capacity. So when it comes to power and performance, it's a big check mark in the win column for 97X 4.2i. At first glance, the Saab 97X and Volvo XC90 appear to provide fairly comparable levels of ride and handling and have similar chassis features. However, upon closer inspection, the 97X 4.2i offers several distinct advantages over the XC90 3.2. Saab 97X features a standard all-wheel drive system that in normal conditions delivers 100% of the engine's power to the rear wheels. But when necessary, up to 100% of available torque can be directed to the front wheels to improve traction. The Volvo XC90 offers all-wheel drive, but only as an option that costs over $1,800. And Volvo's system has a front drive bias, with about 95% of the engine's power directed to the front wheels. If the front wheels lose traction, only up to 50% of power can be directed to the rear wheels. There's also a big difference, and a big 97X advantage in rear suspensions. While the XC90 has an independent multi-link suspension, the 97X provides a five-link solid axle design that includes an electronically controlled load-leveling air suspension. A load-leveling suspension is available only as an extra cost option on the XC90 3.2. The 97X's standard rear limited slip differential helps provide maximum traction in all driving conditions. A limited slip differential isn't even offered on the XC90. While both vehicles also have standard variable assist rack and pinion steering, the 97X provides a tighter turning diameter of just 37.7 feet compared to XC90's more cumbersome 40 feet, making the 97X the more agile SUV when it comes to steering. Finally, the 97X 4.2i provides vented disc brakes at all four corners, while the XC90 has vented discs up front but solid discs in the rear. Vented discs cool faster than solid discs, reducing brake fade and providing superior overall stopping performance. It's just one more reason why, for customers who want a sporty SUV with responsive handling, the clear choice is the Saab 97X. In the mid-size luxury SUV segment, customers have exceptionally high expectations. They want it all: styling, creature comforts, and the kind of versatility and utility that lets them comfortably accommodate passengers and cargo with equal ease. The Saab 97X 4.2i not only meets these customer requirements for refinement, adaptability, comfort, and style, it exceeds them, especially when compared to the XC90. As an example, the Volvo XC90 has an old-school SUV look, with body-side claddings and a utilitarian bumper treatment, as opposed to the Saab's clean, contemporary lines. And when it comes to comfortably accommodating passengers, the 97X provides more first and second row headroom, more first and second row legroom, and more first and second row shoulder room. And while the XC90 offers an optional third row to be able to claim 7-passenger capability, Volvo itself admits that it can only accommodate children, and small children at that. Another example of Volvo's less-than-ideal approach to cargo access is the XC90 tailgate's 70-30 clamshell design. It can be cumbersome and requires opening both pieces of the tailgate separately to gain clear access to the cargo area. Depending on the cargo, customers have to kneel or sit on the bottom part of the tailgate to load or retrieve gear. With the Saab 97X, an easy-to-lift one-piece tailgate makes it easy to stow and retrieve items. And while a cargo cover is available on XC90 as part of the optional convenience package, it's far from convenient. When you do remove the cover, there's no place to store it inside the vehicle. In contrast, the 97X features a standard, easy-to-use, retractable cargo cover that is stored inside the vehicle. 97X also treats its passengers to a higher level of refinement and equipment than the Volvo, including standard leather-pointed seats, heated front seats, power-adjustable driver and front passenger seats, power moonroof, and rear seat climate controls, all extra-cost options on the XC90 3.2. The 97X 4.2i also offers customers the convenience of power-adjustable accelerator and brake pedals, a feature that isn't available at any price on the XC90. Turning to infotainment features, the 97X's standard audio system provides over 100 watts more power than the Volvo system. And if you want the convenience of an in-dash 6-disc CD changer or satellite radio, well, they both cost extra on the XC90. And 97X's new for 2009 standard Bluetooth for phone wireless interface isn't available on the XC90 at all. What's more, 97X also provides a standard OnStar directions and connections plan, featuring turn-by-turn navigation, eNav, and many additional convenience features. OnStar eNav allows subscribers to find and save destinations on MapQuest.com and have those destinations sent to their vehicle's OnStar navigation system, while OnStar turn-by-turn navigation delivers automated voice prompts as you need them turn-by-turn until you arrive at your destination. You won't find OnStar on XC90 because it's not offered at any cost. Although the XC90's base price actually starts below the 97X's, when you equip the XC90 with the optional extra-cost packages necessary to match the 97X's standard features, the XC90 price ends up more than $1,100 over the 97X's. And that still doesn't include all of the Saab's standard luxury features. That adds up to yet another big win for 97X and its buyers. Both the 97X and XC90 offer customers strong reassurances about their vehicle's quality, reliability, and durability, with comparable warranty and no-charge maintenance plans. However, only the Saab provides factory-backed courtesy transportation for all covered warranty repairs and services for a full 4 years or 50,000 miles. That benefit makes the 97X's already outstanding value even more compelling. Both Saab and Volvo have well-earned reputations for safety innovation. 97X and XC90's safety features run the gamut, from dual-stage frontal airbags to rollover sensing systems, and from head curtain side airbags to front passenger sensing systems. The Volvo adds standard front side impact airbags and whiplash protection front seating along with its optional blind spot alert. But with standard OnStar with automatic crash response and many additional safety and security services, 97X buyers have an incredible advantage, one that the Volvo XC90 can't match, because it offers nothing even remotely comparable to OnStar telematics. Both the Saab 97X 4.2i and Volvo XC90 3.2 offer the luxury, versatility, and sporty performance expected of vehicles in their segment. But ultimately, the Saab proves to be the far better choice of the two by exceeding those expectations by a wide margin. In power and performance, the Saab 97X 4.2i offers several advantages over the XC90 3.2, including 50 more horsepower, 40 more pound-feet of torque, and over 1,600 pounds greater towing capacity. In ride and handling, the 97X trumps the XC90 with standard all-wheel drive and a superior all-wheel drive system with 100% of power divertible to the front wheels, plus more standard handling features, including a rear load leveling air suspension and a limited slip rear differential, plus a tighter turning diameter for greater agility and four-wheel vented disc brakes. In comfort and convenience, the 97X tops the Volvo with more contemporary exterior styling, more interior room, more user-friendly access to its cargo area, and more standard features that are extra cost options on the Volvo, including leather-appointed seats, power front passenger seat, heated front seats, rear seat climate controls, a power moonroof, in-dash 6-disc CD changer, satellite radio, and Bluetooth. Plus, there are 97X features you can't get on XC90, including a Bluetooth wireless interface, power adjustable pedals, and OnStar. And on top of it all, the 97X 4.2i costs a lot less than a comparably equipped XC90 3.2. Turning to quality, reliability, and durability, the 97X provides factory-backed courtesy transportation for 4 years or 50,000 miles. That's not available on the XC90. In the important area of safety and security, only the Saab offers customers the safety and security of OnStar with automatic crash response. Add up all of these numerous advantages that the Saab 97X 4.2i enjoys over the Volvo XC90 3.2, and it's easy to see why the clear choice for discriminating mid-size luxury SUV buyers overwhelmingly continues to be the 2009 Saab 97X.